Satan had already picked out my grave. His plan had moved forward to put me away. I drifted so far, would anyone care that I'd soon be lost? I knew my destruction was a matter of time, but Jesus appeared and said, "This one is mine." Now I'm safe from all harm, for he walked through the storm when he came looking for me.
Hello and welcome to Addiction Free. I'm your host, Evangelist Kandi Rose. This is so exciting because I am here at Daughters of the Other Side. I even got to preach. They had a big revival here. I got to hear some of his testimony. And now you're going to hear his testimony on my show. Because, see, this is, as you know, this show is all about bragging on Jesus because none of us could change ourselves. So I have here with me Quentin White. He is the chaplain of The Other Side. The Other Side is a faith-based recovery home for men. And he's going to tell you what that's about here, but he's going to give you his testimony first. So, Quentin, thank you for being my guest.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Well, I'm going to turn this over to him, and he's going to give you his testimony.
All right. My name is Quentin White. I am the chaplain for The Other Side Ministries, but I have not always been a chaplain. I had a long battle with drugs and addiction. I got into manufacturing dope at an early age and done it for a long, long time. And it destroyed my life. I had started with a car wreck and an injury from drugs, from taking Xanaxes and drinking when I was 19. And it broke my back and all my ribs. And I found that nothing would relieve the pain except meth. And if I shot it up, I was good. It didn't hurt. And I could get up and walk and do the physical therapy that the doctors recommended. But what happened, it just spiraled my life out of control. It went into probably a 19, 20-year addiction. I've prison 5 times. Just destroyed my life. But in that, in all that mess I was in, I found that God loved me. You know, I got sent to prison. And when I was in prison, it was the first time that I heard that God loved me and I wasn't going to hell. And it was from there that, it just sparked. It took off. Took many years for it to come to fruition, but in that time of misery and in jail, in the destructive life and the hopeless life, I thought life was just going to be hopeless. I was going to be in and out of prison for the rest of my life. God had other plans for me. And in that, I got off drugs. I was getting indicted by the grand jury. So I quit doing dope because everybody was telling on me. And then I met my wife. We had a baby. Life was good. The baby was stillborn. So I was mad at God, but I knew my child went to heaven. So I wanted to go too. So I started going to church. And in that, God started just revealing himself to me through his word. And all of a sudden, man, everything in my life changed. The things, my desires, my wants changed. All I wanted to do was know more about Jesus. And I wanted to develop that relationship with him. Not what I heard in church or not what people tell me or what the Bible tells me. I wanted an eyeball encounter with the Lord. And in doing that, he sparked something in my life that I don't even know where it's going to end. But right now I'm the chaplain at The Other Side. And that's where my life is. It's through the power of God and the love he has for me. And the plan he had for me before the foundation of the world. Right, now I would like to tell you about The Other Side and what it is. The Other Side, it's a faith-based recovery center for men. It's a 6-month-long program. So I want to reach out to anybody that's needing help. We are located in Wilburn, Arkansas, and we'll take anybody from around the world. As long as you can get there and we have an opening, we will take you. Our program is free of charge. Jesus paid the price for everything, so we don't charge anybody, anything. It's free. And it's a really good program. And I thank y'all for listening. I thank you for your support. And God bless y'all.
Hello, my name is Clint Gardner. I grew up in church. As I was young, growing up in my parents' house, they drug me to church. I was always asleep in church, but I was in church. And throughout high school, I fell into the wrong groups and in the wrong crowds. I wanted to do anything I could and be the best at it that I could. I got into sports, but I started doing drugs and things like Suboxone and pot and drinking and just really, really started going downhill in high school. And I got the bright idea that I could, if I dropped out of high school, I'd stay out of trouble because I'd get away from those influences. But I dropped out of high school and got my GED, and then I started breaking into houses for some reason, and just still hanging in with that rough group and that rough crowd. A couple years down the road, I met my girlfriend who I've been with for 2 years, and the same time I met her, I also met some of my people I thought were my friends, worst people I'd ever met, and started hanging out with them and got addicted to meth for 2 years, and just took me down some really bad hard roads. I started spending all the money I made at my job. I got fired from my job. I couldn't hold a job for a little while, and eventually got rehired. But that 3 years that 2 years that I was addicted to meth, my girlfriend she loved me through it and just saw me through it all and showed me a light I hadn't seen from anyone else, and she always wanted me to come to church and wanted me to get help in a program or something, and I went with her to chapel service at the other side one Saturday. And I tell people they kind of tricked me, but I went with her, and I planned on just returning to the lifestyle after that service. But they interviewed me there, and something stopped me as I was headed back to my seat. And at first I didn't know what it was, but after going through classes and going through the program, I realized it was the Holy Spirit stopped me and was ready for me to come home, come to Christ. And So I stayed at the program. I haven't left yet. I'm still in the program, and God is just totally changing my life. That broken relationship that I had with her has totally changed, turned around. My parents have started coming in and visiting me. Totally changed my relationship with them. I kind of feel like my parents are proud of me now instead of being that black sheep of the family like I always thought I was. Like I always tried to be, but I no longer try to be. I try to be the best I can, the best representation of Christ that I can, and I just owe it all to Him.
All right, hi, everybody. My name's Eric Peckham. Let's see here. I was addicted to opiates and pain pills and cocaine and meth. Started off on pain pills from the age of 18 until the age of, 31. In June, I'll be 2 years clean from that. So it all started when I joined a rock and roll band in college, just hanging out with the guys. I thought it was a cool thing. You see, I always wanted to be accepted, things like that. So I started doing it because they did it, and it eventually just led to me doing it because I liked it. You know, I did it by myself, you know, because I liked the way it felt. So that led with me destroying relationships with my girlfriend at the time, led to me destroying relationships with true friends and with my family. I moved to Little Rock I went to college in Conway, and I moved to Little Rock after that, and that started, there had always been pain pills and stuff like that, but that was where I first started doing heroin, and my two main things that I did was heroin and meth, and that led me to stealing to be able to pay for it, and I got on a path of just thieving and manipulating and in and out of jail, racking up failure to appear. And it was a pretty crazy cycle. And that ended up with me going to jail. And praise God, my mom knew one of the founders of a place called The Other Side. Brother George Ridham, and he said that they were going to be opening up. And I think the sixth guy that was ever there. I did three, but I was the sixth guy that was ever there. And I made it through and graduated. And I'd been graduated for about 2 months. And And I started doing heroin again on the weekends. You know, I had a job, graduated, had my family's trust, had a vehicle, all these things. And I started doing heroin on the weekends. And that led to me, of course, getting physically addicted to it, going around those old people, not having any money to pay the things that I said I was going to pay my parents for. And basically got ostracized from my parents. I got fired from my job. And just basically took off to Little Rock to be a full-time junkie. And I'd overdosed probably 4 or 5 times in from this period when I left my house, you know, got kicked out, took my parents' truck, had to give it back, all that stuff, and overdosed about 5 times, and I ended up in jail. And when I was in jail, I said, God, I don't know what I've done with my life, but I need you to come. I need you to fix it because I made a royal mess of it. And that was the first prayer he ever wanted me to pray. You know what I mean? Like, just I finally got it right. And after I got out of jail, I went back into the other side on June 2017. So I'm coming up on 2 years, and it's just been amazing. It's been an abundant life. He's done exceedingly abundantly above all that I could think or ask. And you know, there are some days that are tough, but he's tougher. You know what I mean? There are some days that are tough, but he's tougher. He's bigger. He's greater, and he's all that I could ever hope for. So all through Jesus. Amen.
Hello. My name is Trent Teague, and I'm 46 years old. I grew up in Chico, Texas. During my younger years, I had it made. My family were good to me. They We didn't go to church a whole lot, but I had everything I wanted and everything I needed. I was very athletic in school. I was all about my sports. I played sports throughout nearly my whole junior high and high school years in high school. Get out of school, I married my high school sweetheart. We had a baby. Was married for 5 years, got a divorce. And that's really when I fell off into my heart addiction. Now, you know, I did the whole drinking in high school and smoking a little marijuana in high school, but it didn't go with my athletics, so I wasn't real big into it. Got a divorce from my first wife, started drinking, going to the bars, and that led to methamphetamine addiction, and I was in my addiction for about 5 years, 4.5 to 5 years on it. Got off of meth, got clean, was clean for about 9-10 years, met my second wife, had 2 children with her, was married 9 years, got a divorce, and again, I started going to the bars, and just fell off into my addiction with methamphetamines again. And then when God delivered me, he brought me to the other side, Wilburn, Arkansas, and my current marriage was broken. My relationship with my children was broken, and God has restored all of that. He has restored my marriage. He's restored my relationship with my children. He's gave me the opportunity to relocate to Heber Springs, Arkansas, so I don't have to go back to the wolf's den, so to say. And I'm just thankful to be able to worship God and his blessings that are continuing to be bestowed upon me and my family every day.
Hi, I'm Anthony Ivey. I'm 45 years old. I was hooked on meth for 27 years, an alcoholic for 30, and it destroyed my life. That's not only my life, just everybody around me. If you were my friend, I'd drug you down with me. And let's see, I was raised in church as a small child, so I knew about God, but I didn't know him. And I fell away from him. Just my life was just such a struggle. I struggled for everything I got. I struggled to keep a job, struggled to keep a vehicle, to get me back and forth to that job that I struggled to keep. And since I've given my life to Jesus, it's not hard. It's not a struggle anymore. It's easy. and he's changed me so much. Yeah, I graduated the other side 2 years ago, a little over 2 years ago. So I've been clean 2.5 years. It's all God, but it amazes me to see how much he changed me. That if you would introduce me to me 5 years ago, I would not even know that guy. And I owe it all to Jesus.
Friends, at this point of the show, I always come on and ask you if you'd like that new life in Christ. You've heard all the devastation that happens when we don't give our life to Christ and we do things our way. And all the problems and all the drama that follows. Heartaches. You know, not saying you won't have heartaches when you follow Christ. But you know what? You will have the Holy Spirit inside of you who will comfort you and guide you and give you that true peace and joy that you always was looking for. You hear my guests tell of the horrible consequences that happened when they continued out there in their addiction. But when they made a whole heart commitment, and that's it, folks, a whole heart commitment. When they made the whole heart commitment to surrender, that's when they received the joy, the peace, and the purpose. So if you'd like that new life, I want to ask you not only to confess Christ, but be willing to repent, which means willing to turn from your old lifestyle. Leave it behind. Don't worry about how you're going to do it. Just be willing. And when you're willing, the Holy Spirit comes in and gives you the power. I'm a former stripper and a prostitute and had multiple addictions, even had a stripping business. But, you know, I had no peace. But when I called on Jesus, when he called on me, he knocked on my heart, showed me who he was. That if I gave my life to him, I would have that peace. And I do have that peace now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I love my new life in Christ. So if you're willing to leave it all behind and ask him to come into your heart, he loves you. Just say this prayer after me. Say, Jesus, forgive me of my sins. Thank you for dying on the cross for me. Thank you for loving me. I'm willing to leave the old life behind and live for you with my whole heart. Thank you for your love, your power, and your forgiveness. I love you too, Jesus. Amen. Now, if you said that prayer and you meant it, you talk to your Heavenly Father. It's all about a relationship with him. He loves you. Go to church, read your Bible, and remember, tell somebody. Because you see, the Bible says, Psalms 107:2, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy. He's redeemed you. Now you go share your testimony. God bless you, and I'll see you next time.
Hi, friends. I'm Barbara Ferguson, and Kandi Rose has asked me to come and talk to you a little bit about some side effects and some issues that you can have from taking drugs. I'm a registered nurse, and I'm bringing you another segment of Addiction Health Dangers. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you about methamphetamines. Some of its effects on the mind are very bad. They can cause terrible insomnia, paranoia, visual and auditory hallucinations, delusions. Delusions can be things like you feel something crawling on your skin. You think people are in the room when they're not really. Such paranoia can result even in homicidal or suicidal thoughts and even carrying them out. The effects on the body are bad too. They can cause extreme anorexia where you get down to where you weigh nothing. You know, you can get down to 80 pounds. Memory loss, severe dental problems, increased physical activity, increased blood pressure, decreased appetite, and hyperthermia, which means your body heat goes way up and is damaging. That can even damage your brain. High doses can elevate body temperature, causing convulsions and even cardiovascular problems, and even death. Please don't do meth. Give your life to Jesus instead.
One pair of hands made the sun and the moon. Every bird, every flower, every tree. One pair of hands formed the valleys, the ocean, the rivers, and the sand. Those hands are so strong, so when life goes wrong, put your faith into one pair of hands. One pair of hands heal the sick. One pair of hands raise the dead. One pair of hands calm the raging storm. And thousands of people were fed. One pair of hands said, I love you. And those hands were nailed to a tree. Those hands are so strong, so when life goes wrong, put your faith into one pair of hands. Those hands are so strong, so when
I'm Sharon Hughes. I'm Executive Director of Daughters of the Other Side. Our home is located in Higginson, Arkansas. We start with a six-month program, phase one, and for those that need help getting their children back, taking care of legals, we offer phase two, where they can stay in a structured environment, a safe place, and continue to grow. And now we have a phase three in Searcy, that allows our girls that's been here a year to go to college and begin to get their children back. And we have the capacity to house around 34 women. And the information of contact is on the screen. And we take women from all of the United States. So you can make contact with us and we'll give you more information. And God bless you.
Greetings in Jesus' name. Teen Challenge Women's Ministries has now changed its name to Adult and Teen Challenge of the Greater South. Why? Well, first of all, we're no longer just women. We have a men's center in Russellville, Arkansas. And of the Greater South, we've opened our fifth state. We are a faith-based recovery program, but first, it starts with a conversation, you reaching out. The only requirement to get in, absolute requirement to get in, is a desire to change.
Hello, I'm Gary Jennings, founder of the Ark of Praise Church and the Father's House. Father's House program is a residential home for men and women struggling with life-controlling problems. We call our program a Christian discipleship program. We're very much about Jesus Christ, and we feel like He is the solution to helping people heal their hearts and changing their lives and restoring families.
I'm Richie and Carly Willis, and we just want to tell you we both were in major addictions in Hot Springs, Arkansas. We both come out of major, major drugs and major, major addictions. We just want to tell you that today we have men's homes in Hot Springs called Solomon's Porch. There's three homes for men. We have our own church today, 411 Highland Street, called Highland Street Revival. We have a roofing company today called Willis & Son Roofing. We have crews working for us and people in the office, and we're just thankful.
This is Pastor Tim and my lovely wife, Leslie. We pastor New Life Church, but we also run Project New Start Recovery Homes. These are homes designed to help men and women overcome addiction, bondages. We deal with any type of bondage that there is. We've been doing this for 20 years. God has just literally changed lives through faith in Jesus Christ. Give us a call at 870-523-8413. God bless.
I'm Lisa Haynes, Clinical Director for Shalom Recovery Centers. Shalom Recovery Centers is a 9-month Christ-centered program. We provide services for both men and women, and we seek to serve those looking for help with life-controlling issues and addiction.
The Harbor Home is really a house of miracles. It is located in a small church in central Arkansas, in Conway, Arkansas, and it's a faith-based program anywhere from 6 months to 1 year, residential for women coming out of drug and alcohol addiction. We have women of all ages that come to the Harbor Home and from all over the United States. And it really is a place where people can come, get down to the real root cause of the issue. Our first 6 months is a time of healing, a time of reflection, and really an opportunity for you to come to realize your value and your worth, and really to develop and cultivate a real relationship with Jesus Christ, which we believe is the answer for all addictive behaviors.
Addictions. Addictions of all types are killing precious people. Overdose of opioids is on the rise. Prescription drugs and alcohol cause families to be torn apart. Everyone suffers, including the children, especially the children. If you or a loved one want help, go to addictionfaithprograms.com to find faith-based resources. There is help. There is hope.
Addiction Free Ministry presents powerful resources written by its CEO, Kandi Rose. Her autobiography, Spirits of Seduction, proves Christ can transform any lifestyle from X-rated to G-rated. Kandi Rose believes testimonies build faith, encouraging others they too can have that new life in Christ. Go to Amazon.com or their website, addictionfreeministry.com, to receive these life-changing resources for yourself or a loved one. There is help. There is hope.
I need to hear somebody testify. I need to hear somebody say, yeah, that you were lost and at the bottom, and you could not find your way. Just when life had lost all meaning, and you wish that you could die, Jesus came to you that day. You invited him to stay. I need to hear somebody.
Hi friends, once again, this is Kandi Rose, thanking you for tuning in. Come back every week if you can, and please tell others. My theme scripture is Psalms 107:2. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy. So I encourage you now to go share your testimony. And as you walk the walk, which is important, others will want who you have, Jesus. So let's make a difference. Jesus truly loves you, and so do I. My website is addictionfreetv.com.